Hello, my name is Eric, and it's Mother's Day 2023. And I was feeling very nostalgic, you know. So I've decided to do this podcast on my mother and my grandma. Welcome to the craziness that lives inside. First off, I wasn't a perfect child. Then I could say my parents weren't perfect parents. But I got very nostalgic thinking about growing up in the 60s and 70s and all the stuff I used to do behind my mom's back, you know. I would never tell my mother what I did when I was in my teenager. Oh my God. But now that they're gone and I am older, and sometimes I do wake up in the middle of the night. One time I woke up in the middle of the night and said, oh God, I gotta call my mom. Then it dawned on me after a couple of seconds, she's gone. I mean, I haven't been doing that for a while, but when my mom first passed away back in 2010, it was like almost every other day, I would do something, and all of a sudden, I gotta call my mom, and then. So, it takes time heals all wounds, as they say. So, but anyway, I was feeling very good this morning when I woke up, and I text everybody Happy Mother's Day, and I text a cousin of mine, my cousin Cynthia. I text her, and she said, you know, she doesn't have any children. She has a little puppy, whatever. She said, that's the only child you got, but thank you very much. And then I text her back and let her know that when my grandmother was alive, she would send me Mother's Day cards every Mother's Day. And I would ask my grandmother, Grandma, why are you sending me a Mother's Day card? You know, I'm not a mother. You know, why are you sending me a Mother's Day card? She said, oh, you always send me one, so I figured you should get one. And then I thought about it, but I didn't drag my brain through it. Because my cousin said to me, well, she knew. I mean, I did think about, well, if you go to send me a card, wouldn't you send me a Father's Day card? Even though I'm not a father. But she decided to send me Mother's Day cards. So maybe she didn't know. I didn't press the issue. In those days, you don't press the issue. If a parent or any grown-up have any inkling that you think have any inkling of you being gay, you kept it to yourself. You don't push the issue. Because, you know, let's face it, you know, you don't want to go to hell. That's what my grandmother probably said. You go, I mean, I'm going to be honest with you. Her and I used to get into these religious arguments. And she said something to me. I don't know what I said. I'm always running off with the mouth. You know how it is. And she said, you shouldn't say stuff like that. That's blasphemy. And what does it mean, blasphemy? You shouldn't say that. You know, God's going to get you. I said to her, I said, let me tell you something. If you believe that God is everywhere, and I said, God knows what I'm thinking, that he know doggone well, or he or she know doggone well what I'm going to say in those situations. If he or she didn't want me to say it, they wouldn't let me say it. You know that old expression? God don't like ugly, he strike people down by lightning. Well, I should have been struck down by lightning 1,000 times by now. Anyway, I don't want to rant on, which I can. I just want to wish Happy Mother's Day to everybody that I know. I did text a lot of people. If I didn't text you and I didn't put it on Facebook or Twitter, Happy Mother's Day. Whether you're a man, woman, or whatever, Happy Mother's Day. Thank you for listening to the craziness that lives inside my head. Sometimes I feel